I've got my phone and it's got GPS tracking on it, just in case.
You come prepared, smart.
Yes, let's call it that.
I was a little bit surprised that you said yes to come out today. Yeah, I color outside the lines just a little bit. You're running a board right there, and grab. And the big reveal.
Okay. There's not a whole lot here, actually.
There's actually not much to be seen up here. All the business end is all underground. Just be careful ducking in through the door.
Maybe I shouldn't have wore a skirt. This way. Okay.
These are the original blast doors for the silo. There's two of them to protect against an outside nuclear blast.
Okay. How far down does this go? Oh my goodness. Oh, I think you got some work to do. So, if you had to come down here in case of an emergency, don't you think you'd get lonely?
That's why I invited you out. And it is a situation where you could get lonely.
Okay. Fair forward for a second date.
Creepy. I think she got hit pretty hard with the smell of old and the 50 years of decay that's gone on here up until this point.
This is very raw, maybe, yeah. And don't worry about the structural safety.
Jeff can sense that Stephanie's not impressed.
Watch your step across.
So he has saved the best part of his tour for last.
You're not afraid of heights, are you?
No. Oh, my land.
Jeff Flanagan thinks life after the economic doomsday he fears might be lonely, so he's looking for a compatible mate to complement his survival plan. But so far, Stephanie's not impressed with his future subterranean home.
You're not afraid of heights, are you?
Jeff hopes that he can save their second date by showing her the heart of his business cycle.
My plan.
17 stories deep, it once held an intercontinental booster weapon, but now it houses Jeff's most valuable prepper resource.
This was the prepper gold mine. There's 1.4 million gallons of water pre-stored.
While the silo was vacant for more than 50 years, it collected 1.5 million gallons of rainwater, enough to fill 2 Olympic-sized swimming pools.
And an added bonus is, you can harmonize with yourself. So, you're a singer? Can we give it up?
I do, actually. This seems really fun. Can I go out and stand on the edge and do it?
That is amazing.
That is so neat.
I don't sound like that when I'm down there.
Jeff wants Stephanie to appreciate the silo for more than its acoustics. He wants to see if she has the prepper mentality it takes to survive by helping him retrieve his water supply.
How do you get to it? I mean, that's Lice now.
We have to go get it.
How?
Repellent. Rope work. Go for it.
Me? No. No.
I'm willing to go down if you can help me and be safety at the top.
Please tell me you've done this before.
Damn.
Seems like there could be easier ways, like drop a submersible pump or something like over the edge.
It isn't a good proper mentality, I like that. Let's go do this, give me a hand, getting over this ledge.
This date has been full of nervous moments.
So you can't trust me with the life hole and trust you with the ropes?
Water passes through the filter. Impurities are trapped by the sand grains' coarse surface.